introduce you. Some of my...
Excuse me, Barb. Look, I know we agreed to have you do the show because Irvin, the female impersonator, couldn't make it. But this is beyond our control, not the Barb Richards variety show. Roll the opening.
We'll be back with the Barb Richards Gala Extravaganza.
Beyond our control.
Beyond our control after these messages.
Live from the Junior Achievement Center on the outskirts of beautiful South Bend, Indiana, it's the Barb Richards Gala Extravaganza Variety Show.
Howdy out there, ladies and gents, and welcome to my Gala Extravaganza Variety Show. Me, well, shoot, I'm Barb Richards, and have we got a show for you. Tonight, we have with us a very special guest, a man known and loved all over this great land of ours. Bob Gilligan Denver is with us tonight, ladies and gentlemen. What a personality. What a man. And what a sense of humor, I must add. All right, we've got a lot to do. So let's get the ball rolling with a little improvisation. Okay, great. All right, I'll let the studio audience help me. Okay, guys, give me a character.
A chicken.
Okay, a chicken. A chicken. Oh. Now a situation. Where am I? Great. I'm trapped in an elevator. I'm certainly not in this elevator alone. Give me some people. Who am I with?
Winston Churchill. Karl Marx.
I'll say Tom.
A Chinese chicken.
Rand Tarkington. My Uncle Ed.
Your Uncle Ed.
Yeah, the boat.
That's enough. So I'm in here with a bunch of communists and famous TV personalities. So what do I do to get us out? What else? I simply act as a mediator between the communists, the Allied forces, and the National Football League, stressing the advantages of a peaceful world and Monday Night Football. They will all agree in the end. And we will be rescued from the threat of war and the pay hike. Oh, thank you. Thank you. You're very kind. Oh, now we move it right along to the next sketch, where we find it's not so happy of a day at St. Vivian's Hospital. Oh, doctor, what happened to this poor man?
You tell me. I don't even know which end is up.
I think this end is up.
Oh.
Well, what are you going to do?
I wonder what the professor would do.
Oh, I should think he'd probably recommend 200 milligrams of salicylic acid, followed by a sufficient rest period, after which the patient would notify us of his condition.
Well, how about if we just have him take 2 aspirin and call us in the morning?
That's what I said.
Oh.
Can't you think of anything else?
How about if we have him take 4 aspirin and call us in 2 days?
No. You're being absolute no help at all.
Well, I'm hungry. Think I could have some of that coconut cream pie you baked this morning?
No, not until you do something with your patient.
Well, can't we just send him to the Our Lady of the Skipper Hospital?
No, he's your patient. He's your responsibility. You ought to do something. You ought to operate.
Operate? Not me. Oh, no, Skipper.
Doctor? Doctor? You know, Bob and I go way back. In fact, we go all the way back to St. Swithin's High School. Right, Bob? What happened, Bob? Bob?
Well, when I hit my head, I think I turned it into a radio. This is one of the few clear stations.
Yes. Well, anyway, we've had a lot of good times, many fond memories together. And I think that that is what life is all about. Everybody sticking together and helping each other out. special, and I'd like to thank all my guests for being on my show, and that reminds me of a song that's very special to me, and I hope it touches you just as much.
When you think about it.
Oh. Well, here's your button anyway. That's the end of Beyond Our Control, not the Barb Richards stuff. Roll the clothes.